गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरी वन. दिस साइड भविष्या वर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम SD कॉलेज अम्बाला कैंट. एंड द टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ हायर एजुकेशन इन इंडिया. एंड इन द अर्लियर सेशंस वी हैव कवर्ड द टॉपिक सच एज एजुकेशन इन एंशिएंट इंडिया, एजुकेशन इन मॉडर्न एरा, व्हाट आर द कमीशंस एसोसिएटेड विद द प्री इंडिपेंडेंस पीरियड एंड द पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस पीरियड. देन वी हैव कवर्ड द वैल्यू एजुकेशन, एनवायरमेंट एजुकेशन एंड द पोर्टल्स दैट आर एसोसिएटेड विद एजुकेशन. एंड देन ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट then all the important programs launched by MHRD. And now the last part of the higher education will be covered, that is governance part. And in the governance part, we will be learning about the Constitution of India, the Supreme Court, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, Niti Aayog, President of India and Prime Minister of India. So we'll be starting with the Constitution of India. So Constitution of India was completed on 26th November 1949, but it was legally enforced only after the 2 months, that is on the January 26th, 1950, and that day is also known as the Republic Day of India. Indian Constitution is the longest constitution and the lengthiest constitution among all the constitutions in the world. The Constitution of India is neither the typed nor the printed one, but both the versions of Constitution, that is in Hindi and English, are handwritten, and it's the only constitution in the world that is handwritten. Originally, when the Constitution was made, it comprises of 395 articles in 22 parts and 8 scheduled, but after doing the amendments, that is 103 amendments that have been made, it comprises of 448 articles in 25 parts and 12 schedules. The ideals of liberty, equity and fraternity in our preamble have been taken from the French Revolution, which is also a French motto. The Constitution is partly rigid because certain provisions can be amended by the two-third majority in the parliament and ratified. That means it needed to be signed by at least 50% of the states, and remaining provisions can be amended by the parliament in two-third majority. The Constitution is partly flexible because certain provisions of the constitutions can be amended by the simple majority in the parliament. Indian Constitution contains both features of federal constitution and unitary constitution. Federal means when a center government does not interfere in the state government, and state government can take its own decisions for the certain kinds of development that the state have to make, and center do not has any interference in that. And unitary means when the central government has a control over certain positions, and decision regarding that positions will be only taken by the central government. So the federal feature of Indian Constitution is rigid constitution, division of power, supremacy and independence of judiciary. That means state can take their decisions regarding the developments on their own, and center has nothing to do with that. And unitary features of the Indian constitutions are union of states, representation in the legislature, appointment on key positions, disturbance in the state, unified judiciary, power to make law, power to form new states and to change existing boundaries, and emergency provisions. See, all these kinds of powers are only in the hands of central government, and regarding these powers only decision can be taken by the central government. So now comes the Supreme Court. Supreme Court came into existence on the similar day, that is 26 January 1950, and it is the apex court in India. It is located at the Tilak Mark New Delhi. It is a constitutional body. The function of Supreme Court is that it is the custodian of the constitution and the uppermost court for the appeal, which listens to all the appeals in opposition of the verdicts of high courts of the union territories and state. It consists of Chief Justice of India and 30 other judges designated by the President of India, and the retirement age of a Supreme Court judge is 65 years. So the function of Supreme Court is that whenever a person who is not satisfied by the decision of the High Court of a state can send an appeal in the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court has to listen to that appeal and give the final judgment regarding that appeal. And if and the Supreme Court's judgment will be the final judgment after the appeal has been listened or the judge has given a decision, then there can be no changes made. And Supreme Court also has the power to listen to the mercy pleas of the various prisoners that have been given the decision of hanged. The Parliament of India or the legislature is divided into two houses, namely the upper house and the lower house, or the two sabhas are namely as Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is called as the lower house and the Rajya Sabha can be addressed as the upper house. You can see that the Parliament of India is in circular position. Its circular position represents its continuity. The Parliament of India doesn't have a gap of more than 6 months between its two sessions. It means that there must be at least two sessions of Parliament in a 1 year. In general, there are three sessions of the Parliament. First is the budgetary session, then comes the monsoon session, then comes the winter session. The budget session is from February to March. The monsoon session is between July to September, and the winter session is between November to December. So monsoon session is the longest session, and while the winter session is the shortest session. So now comes the Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha is the also known as upper house of the Parliament of India, and the tenure of the Rajya Sabha is of 6 years. You can see that the carpet in the Rajya Sabha is of red color, which denotes the royalty and also tells about the sacrifice done by the freedom fighters. See, this question is important, that which color of the carpet in Rajya Sabha and what it denotes, because it have been asked in the previous year NET exams. So read this point carefully. As per the Article 80 of Indian Constitution, the maximum strength of Rajya Sabha is of 250 members, out of which 238 members represents the states and the union territories. 12 members are nominated by the president. Maximum seats are of Uttar Pradesh, that is 31, Maharashtra 19, and Tamil Nadu, that is 18. The qualification of Rajya Sabha member: one should be the citizen of India and should be at least 30 years old. 1/3 of the members must retire once in 2 years, and their places are filled by the fresh elections. The Vice President of India is known as ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. That means he is the speaker at the Rajya Sabha and he holds the session of the Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha passes a resolution by the majority of not less than 2/3 of the members present and the voting declaring that is necessary in the national interest to create one or more all the Indian services common to union and the state. Parliament becomes empowered to create by the law such services. It means that there is no requirement